welcome back. We're still doing the German Shorthead Pointer. Now, it's been a few days since I was able to do any work on this. And I've been looking at this and thinking, it doesn't look like a German pointer at all. Not yet, anyway. And my brother's been round, and I showed him how far we've got. And it says, it looks like a Fizzler. And I thought, he's right, you know, it does. So, we've got ourselves more pictures, and pictures that really hopefully are going to help me get the look right. And one of the main things I think is this snout. We need to take more off there, and we need to take quite a bit off around the nose. We've got very prominent noses, these dogs. We need to open the nostrils up. The nostrils are quite big. And then we need to do a bit of work maybe around the eyes, and a bit more work on the ears to make them look a bit more like the pointer here. So that's what we've got to do. Again, you know, you go on Google and you get these pictures, and I've been quite selective about these. There's reasons for each picture, really. Each one of them is showing me a little bit of what I want, so that's what we're going to refer to. We've still got our other pictures on the other side here, as you can see, but these are the ones I'm going to use more now. What I did find while I was looking at these pictures was this one, and isn't that a brilliant picture? Now, to me, that would be exactly right for a front profile. So we're going to save that. We're going to reduce it in size because obviously, you know, it's going to be too big as it is. We reduce that in size and use that as a front profile. I think that's absolutely fabulous. What you could do, you could have your carving on the back, just draw your salient points, so you've just got a line drawing on there, get nice and black, put that on the scanner, reduce it, and if you've just got simple black lines, the scanner should deal with that fairly easily. So I'm just going to go and find my mask, whatever it is, and then we'll start work. Right, we're back, got the mask on, and we're going to start work. So, first thing, find some pencils. Now, something interesting this weekend, came across a strip light, £23 LED, plug it in, sorted. 5 minutes to put up. The light is really, really good in here. I think it's better than this spot, because I don't think it throws as many shadows about. So we're going to get some more of those and put them in. The guys are pretty good, so we'd say, well, good lighting, £23 strip light, B&Q, if you don't pay me to advertise. Right, off we go. So I think what we need to do is take material off around the nose, both sides, and we're going to be a bit careful. We don't want to go at it like a mad thing. But say, they're quite prominent noses, these, and then we need to try and slim all that down. So here we go. Again, refer to your pictures. Thank you. say, I don't like working on this side. It's I find it very awkward. I'd try and find myself a nice position to work in. So what we're going to do now is this area here, we're going to reduce that both sides. When you look at these, they do have a little concave here, creates a little bit of squareness I think on the nose. So we'll change over some pieces. What I'm going to do now is take material off this area here, both sides. Now what I'm going to do now is this area here, flatten that off a bit of a concave, but we want to leave, you can see that there, pencil marks, not too strong, leave that area there, so same both sides. We'll put a sanding disc on all these deep scratches, but we'll do for now. Change over again. Now the other thing that I have noticed, and it's not with all the dogs but most of them, these lips go up at quite a V. Some of them are not quite as angled, but a lot of them are. So we're going to just put a little bit more V on there. That one, so that we can cut around there.
Thank you.
So the next thing I think is just put a bit of detail in where the lips fold round. Not sure how we're going to approach this, but So just to show you what we're doing, we're just doing these little bits here, and you do get a wee bit of concave in there, so we've done that, but we need to tie this up with underneath. So looking at these, I think the material we've got here, we need to remove that. You can see it on some, you don't see it on all of them. I'm just trying to get an impression of depth. We've gone over the 17 minutes 20 minutes, so we'll let this run to half an hour, then we'll start again. As I say, we don't want these videos to get too long for you. I'm just going to use this little carbide just to do the lips underneath. I'm going to put it in the foredom because I want a bit more torque. I'm getting a lot of torque off that Chinese dental thing at times. So thank you. And I'm going to use that little tungsten carbide now, like a, what do you call it really, oval. And I have to take the edge off the lips underneath. What we're going to do, when we cut the profile, we left a little bit proud there, that's already shown underneath, so we're going to remove that because that obviously that ridge there is not needed, it's just part of the original cut, so we're just going to remove that a little bit. So it might be time to put a little sanding disc on this now. Yeah. We're just going to put a bit of a radius now on these bottom lips. Just take the edge off. Right, you're at 38 minutes. I'm going to stop you now and we'll come back.